Hey guys, Ezra here again with another do-it-yourself video. Today we're going to be working on a 2007 Lexus GS 350 and replacing the leaking water pump. The water pump is a common issue, and mine at around 90,000 miles had a pretty badly leaking pump, and most of the fluid is actually gone. So we're going to go ahead and do that today. Now what you're going to need is a new water pump, 2 gallons of Toyota Long Life coolant, deep metric sockets and extensions, torque wrenches in inch pounds and foot pounds, a drive belt, an idler pulley are optional. You're going to also need pliers and a channel lock wrench and blue thread locker. First, you're going to go start off by removing the engine cover clips. These simply pop off and you can remove the cover. We're going to go ahead and remove the front cover and the passenger side plastic cover. I broke a few of these, snapping them off, so be careful. You can buy new ones on eBay. Now we're going to go ahead and remove the engine cover. It just simply pulls off. Now use a 10mm socket to remove the single bolt holding in the intake snorkel. Also disconnect the negative battery terminal as a precaution. That uses also a 10mm bolt or wrench. Here's my dad just checking out,
pink stuff all over the place.
Checking out the engine.
That's the pump. That's the coolant coming out. The pump is just, no, it's pink. See, this is pink. Mm. And then this is the pump right here. So I just need to take this off, and then I get access to that already. I have one.
All right. So at the bottom of the engine, there are 7 bolts holding in a engine plastic cover. So it's a pretty small plastic cover. I actually could take it off without jacking the car up. It's a little piece that's broken too from the previous owner. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and remove the radiator cap. What we're gonna be doing is draining the radiator, so it'll be hopefully less messy when we undo the hoses and the inlet assembly. Now there's a white screw that's easily accessible from the top. Open that up and it should just start pouring out. There's a good amount of fluid in there, so it might take a while for it to drain. I'm not draining completely out, I just want to get most of it out so when I remove the hoses it won't be too messy. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and remove 6 coolant hoses from the inlet assembly. That's the thing in the middle with the radiator cap. I disconnect the reservoir hose, drain a little bit of fluid out of there. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and remove one of the hose clamps on the radiator hose. And now we're removing the hose clamp from the lower radiator hose. Again, removing another hose clamp from a smaller coolant hose. And there would be 2 more clamps that I will have to remove. Using a 10mm socket, go ahead and remove the 2 bolts holding in the reservoir, coolant reservoir. Should just pull right out of there after these bolts are removed, like so. Just gently wiggle that hose off the inlet assembly. Scoot that that hose clamp a little bit further back, so it gives me a little more loosens up the hose a little bit. And should just pop right off. This would be a good time to replace your hose if it needs replacement. Now there are a few plastic bolt nuts holding these plastic covers in. Make sure you take those out. These are just hand tight for me. I'm going to go ahead and just move that out of the way for now. If you have trouble removing some of these hoses, sometimes just clamping a little lightly with pliers and then twisting it to break the seal often helps remove hoses that have never been removed before. Removing another coolant hose at the bottom of the inlet assembly. Oops, this still had coolant in it. Just let it drain. Alright, so another one of these smaller hoses at the top. Just gently twisting it back and forth to loosen up the hose. So what I found actually is using my thumbs in this kind of lever fashion, and I was able to just slide the hose off the inlet assembly. Pulling at it with your thumb and finger doesn't seem to work really well like that. Using your thumbs, both thumbs, opposite of each other, and just sliding it off seems to work the best. There you go. I only counted 6 hoses. That seemed to be all I needed to remove. Alright, as you can see in the diagram, there are 4 bolts and 1 nut. If you need to look at the diagram, go ahead and rewind and pause the screen. Do note you do need a deep socket for one of these because it is a nut with the stud going through it. A standard socket will not have the length needed to undo that nut. As of course, make sure your work area is organized. times like these, I really wish I had an electric ratchet. All right. When you remove the inlet assembly, there's going to be a cascade of coolant coming down. So make sure you have a drip pan ready and cover your work area unless you want your driveway covered in coolant. Just pull it back towards you, toward the front of the car, and that should just wiggle right out. If you notice that black plastic piece on the inlet assembly, that is the thermostat. If you want to replace that, go ahead and do so. It's like the heart of the engine. Looks like one at least. Anyways, inspecting the coolant or the water pump area, as you can see, there's coolant everywhere. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and loosen four bolts on the water pump pulley, as noted in the diagram. Again, feel free to pause it. We're doing this because the tension on the belt holds the pulley still enough for us to loosen it at this point. Without the belt, you would need a special Toyota tool. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and remove the drive belt. This requires a socket and a wrench, and we're going to go ahead and lift the wrench toward the passenger side or up in a sort of counterclockwise motion that will loosen the belt enough for you to slide it off. I'm not really sure why I'm unscrewing the bolts on the pulley, but I do, and either way, the belt does come off. You shouldn't need to remove the pulley at this point, though. Alright, the belt and the water pump pulley are removed. Alright, let's take a look at this pulley. As you can see, there's a lot of dried up coolant. It's that pink crusty stuff. That's definitely an indicator that there's something leaking behind there. Good thing we got that out. I'm also going to go ahead and replace this drive belt. It's old enough anyway. So on my particular car, there's a lot of crusted coolant all over the front of the engine. I just use a brush and my hand to clean most of that off. Now there's going to be a injector drive. It's like a small black box on the left side of the engine. There's going to be a few of those plastic nuts, and then a bolt at the bottom of the unit. It's kind of hard to see from the top, but it's there. You can feel for it like I just did there. All right, this is me moving the injector drive to the side. You don't actually need to disconnect it at all. Just simply wedging it in a way that it will stay out of the way is perfectly fine. All right, so right now I'm unwrapping the new water pump. It's Aisin brand from Rock Auto, made in Japan. It's also the maker of the original pump. Just testing the bearing, making sure it's okay. All right, so 14 millimeter bolt for the idler pulley. Gonna go ahead and remove that. We need to remove it in order to get to the pump. Alright, so we're going to also remove the tensioner pulley. Be careful, it is reverse threaded, so you're going to have to tighten it clockwise to loosen it. Alright, so here's a diagram of the water pump. There are 16 total. They're also 10 and 12 millimeter. Go ahead and pause that so you can see where all the bolts are. But I'm going to go ahead and fast forward this because it's pretty time consuming with a manual wrench. Also, I noticed a few of the bolts have thread locker. You want to keep track of which ones do and don't. So in order to do that, what I do is I have the new pump on the ground like that. And as I remove bolts, I also stick them into where they would go in the new pump. Just to keep track of the order and the size. So fast forwarding all of this. This is probably the most time-consuming part of the job. Alright, so just as you start loosening the final couple bolts, the pump is going to start leaking a lot of fluid just like that. So you really want to make sure you have something to catch that. Luckily I have cardboard and a small pan. And out goes the old pump. So what I'm going to do is transfer all the bolts in their order to the old pump so I can get the new pump ready to install. I also give a final count to make sure I have all 16 bolts. Doing a little quick cleaning of the front gasket mating surfaces. Just wiping it down with a towel. Okay, so my kit came with a O-ring for the inlet assembly. I just pull that off and then just put the new one on. It's pretty simple and straightforward. Go ahead and line up the gasket for the water pump with the new water pump and get ready to replace some of the screws just to hold it in there. Something I didn't show either was installing the O-ring. You can see sort of above my right hand on the water pump assembly. The kit that you should buy should come with one of those O-rings. So simply just set it in there. Make sure it doesn't fall out as you're installing the water pump. So right now I'm just loosely hand threading bolts in to hold the pump into position while I start putting thread locker on the other bolts and torquing them down. The manual doesn't specify any particular order, so all I did was pretty much what you would do typically is a diagonal star pattern. So I worked from outside in, alternating each side.
Wait, can you bring him back inside? There's coolant everywhere. Where's Red?
At this point, I realize my dog is out and about, and those of you that don't know, dogs smell coolant and think it's something potable and try to drink it and they end up killing themselves. So I have to usher my poor dog back in. He's so old, but he is the best dog ever. It always takes a bit to coax him back into the house. He loves the outdoors. As small as he is.
What is that?
Of course, treats always work.
Okay, turn the lights off, right? At night. All right. Red, go. He's so slow.
But yeah, make sure you don't have any pets around because of that coolant. Anyways, here are the torque specs for all of the bolts for the water pump. Make sure you note the A and B and C designations. Make sure if you want to see that torque spec again and that screenshot, go ahead and rewind and pause the video so you can get a good look at the order and not the order, but the type of bolt and the torque value required. So here I am fast forwarding the video again. It's just me threading in and using thread locker on the specific bolts and then torquing them down with a wrench. It's just that easy. This is literally the most time consuming thing. Removing the pump and installing the pump. 16 bolts just for the pump. Installation, though, and assembly is reverse of removal, pretty much. So after you get all these torque values down,
Really, the rest of the job is fairly straightforward. It's just assembling what you disassembled. So right now I'm using a inch-pounds torque wrench. Some of the values are too low for my bar-type torque wrench to measure accurately. So I have to use a finer tool, something that's relatively inexpensive. I just bought this on Amazon. It worked perfectly for this job, at least. So basically, I'm rechecking all the torque values for the finer bolts, making sure I have all of those torqued properly. If you don't have a torque wrench in your toolbox, please get one. It's very handy. Gives you peace of mind also that you're torquing things to factory specs. Alright, again, giving a final cleanup now that the pump is back and installed. Again, reverse. Installation is reverse of removal, so we're going to go ahead and replace the injector drive. Also, making sure you get that hidden bolt underneath. Sometimes you're just going to have to feel for it with your fingers. Or if you have a mirror, that would help as well. Here we are, we're going to go ahead and reinstall the idler pulley. This one is not reverse threaded. I think we're coming about to the end of the video. Really, the rest of the parts are reverse of removal. All right, guys, thanks for watching another do-it-yourself video. I hope this helped you in your next water pump job on your Lexus GS. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe.